In this current lesson, well, we get to finish the Let's Connect section. So we can click on those ones and you can see the info boxes appear over there and we can close them and so on. So, yay! Triple, triple, bam, bam, bam. This is me. We haven't fixed that. I will fix that some other time. No. I'm happy that, well, I finished updating this with more or less the links, the labels, descriptions, and so on. So it looks more or less like in the final version, if not possibly the final version. But I always update things. So anyway, so we got codetap, GitHub, LinkedIn, Stack Overflow, CodeWars, Udemy, Facebook, Skype, Instagram, blah, 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 lots of them, right? Cool. Now, let's see actually what happens here, right? So if we look at this description box with arrow, right? It sits inside this column, and then there is another column, which has another description box with arrow and so on, right? So actually, description box with arrow sits inside columns, which is not what I was expecting. Okay, give me a second. I got lost. No. Come on. Connect. Yeah. Hit this one.
Okay.
Let's remove this for a second. I'm not sure what will happen, but let's remove it for a second. And shift tab. Save it. Now let's see. It's messed up. Okay. Undo. Okay. So the thing is, I want to somehow target something over there, but it's not going to work as expected. I need to add something else over here. Some kind of identifier. Okay. Let's add the description box. Control C. Space here. Control V. So the attribute description box with the value of key plus one. Hey, that's a string. Okay, let's save it. So it's going to be, instead of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on. So it's not going to start from 0. It doesn't matter that much anyway, but let's see what I've done. Because right now we got this div, come on, this div has description box 1. This div has description box 2. And to make it even like whatever, W3 schools compliant or whatever, let's add data minus.
Data
minus?
Minus?
Yeah, that's it.
Like this?
Yeah, data description box. Anyway, so we got data description box and we know that it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10. So far, I think we are on the same page. Actually, let's look into the inspector. Okay. So it's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10, right? With data description box. Now, when we click on one of those labels that activates one of those inputs, we can do something. What can we do? Okay, this is the label. It activates this input, right? So now I can use the nth-of-type selector or pseudo selector to actually select some of those connect radio inputs with type radio. Okay, copy that. Let's try something. Let's connect. Yeah. Okay. So connect CSS, enter, paste. But I think we already have connect radio somewhere. Just a second. Connect disk. Connect router. No, I don't. Okay, so it's a class anyway.
Yep.
So connect radio, but not like that. Oh, leave it. So connect radio. Let's try one manual and then we figure out how to make all of them work. So the connect radio as nth of type 3. Colon. That's nth of type and 3. And let's do border 5 pixels, not border 5 pixels solid red. Okay, let's see what happens. Well, nothing happened. Did they say connect disk? Ah, we said connect radio.
Yes.
Anyway, control C. We don't intend to get with this until the end, but anyway, plus, dot control V, dot. Let's see.
Same.
No, but that's the point, because you can't really see it. nth-of-type 3 plus that should give the connect disk. Well, it doesn't give any border. I don't see any border here. Do you see any?
No. Can you reset it, maybe? If you can reset the page, maybe we'll...
Well, it doesn't matter.
I was thinking that.
Connect radio nth-of-type. Because it's not plus colon. It's colon after it. Then connect this. Maybe that's not. So the dot colon space. Yeah. Okay, so yeah, it does work. Okay, so the point is, what I try to prove is that if we say nth-of-type at that input, because we cannot use nth-child. Nth-child works on every child, no matter what there are. And we only want to count the ones that fall into this selector. So nth-of-type means whatever we find with this selector, right?
Yep.
So I got connect radio, nth-of-type 3. Now, when this one is checked, by the way, when this one is checked, so checked. Okay, we want to select, but now we are not going to use the sibling selector, we are yes, the adjacent selector. One is sibling, one is adjacent. I think plus is adjacent and tilde is sibling. Anyway, plus selects the very next one, tilde selects any of the ones following after, right? So here comes the thing. Right? If we go into the connect and we know that, well, those columns or those description box with arrow are the ones that, copy this please, are the ones that hold the info boxes. We can go into here and control F, actually it's here, and do DN. Yeah, save it. So now if we go back to over here, we can see that the info boxes are gone.
Yeah.
Kaput.
Dead.
Yeah. So the point is, now I can say adjacent selector, tilde.
Wait a second. Why is it not working?
Because you're not pressing shift.
Shift.
Yeah. Okay. So then I want to select any that follows later. So in the connect thing, we got this one. So let's copy it. And is it a div or what? It looks like a div. It doesn't matter anyway. So paste it in here. But this, paste is an attribute. No, it's not tag. Undo. Okay, and the value of it would be this one.
Is like this or three?
Come on, undo. Yeah. Okay, so now I'm saying, okay, when the third, well, let's say input, is checked, it has a checked state. I want you to find the data description, well, the tag that has a data description box attribute with the value of 3, right? And inside it, come on, where is it? Here, this one. Copy. And inside it, paste. Space. Okay. Display initial.
Initial.
Yeah, save it. Let's see now what happens. So there is no box. We click on the first one. We click on the second one. We click on the third one, and the box is there. With the exception that it doesn't have a background, but anyway. Why it doesn't have a background? Any idea?
Let's see what it's saying.
Display initial. Background color, right?
Is there?
Has a column. Maybe not display initial. Okay, let's remove this and play with them. Block works fine. Okay. Block. Save it. So now, again, well, I'm closing it, by the way, because now I can close it. I click, and then it shows. Now, all we need to do is make it work for all the other ones, because right now, if I click on this one, it should show something, but it doesn't, because nothing is configured to show over there, but this one is configured to show. Anything else hides it, which should show another info panel, and this one just closes it.
Cool.
So, how are we doing with time? It's enough. Okay, cool. So, now, let's do a for in SAS. So, it's with at from the email, at for, and that's cool. And this, let's do it I from 1 to 10. And let's move this inside it, remove this. And now, if we save it, it's going to generate 10 times, but this with 3.
The same one, yeah.
So this one, somewhere there needs to be some interpolation. I'm not sure exactly how we do this, but let's try with hash curly braces. No, hash is like ds.
Ds?
No, hash, pound. Yeah, that's the one. Curly braces.
For this one.
Curly braces.
This one, yeah?
Are you super excited?
Yeah.
Look the hash back. Okay, and inside here, I. Now, I hope it works. Control C, Control V, and let's save it. It needs one more parenthesis here.
Yeah.
Or not. Undo. Okay.
Yeah.
Copy. No, you need a dollar here because the variable is dollar I. Okay. Copy. Paste. Save it. Now I hope it works. Otherwise, we try with dollar and something else.
Yeah, we add more.
Well, one. It kind of works. Well, Twitter doesn't work. Okay, I think I know why. So 1 to 10, it stops before 10, and we can do 1 through 10, through. Yeah. Save it. Okay, so now this one works as well, see? You can close it, you can open it, you can close, open. Anyway, it works.
You can use this it. All of them, yeah.
This is it. It definitely works. Not sure why. There are lots of... Okay, let's do display none. I want to do display none because there are lots of, let's say, grids that have nothing to be displayed in them, but actually we don't want to display the grid itself because if you see there are like lots of spaces.
Grids or these.
Okay, so anyway. Where did we say display none? We say display none inside this arrow, right? Control X. Okay, so we want to say paste this one here. Okay. Copy this. Paste it somewhere here. Okay, remove that. Curly braces. Move this down. Yeah, and now this is display none, and then remove this, save it, let's see. So now we no longer hide, well, the intention is to no longer hide the info box inside the column, we want to hide the column. Okay, so if you see now it sits like nicely there over there. You can definitely close it.
Cool.
So now the column that holds the box is hidden, see? Nice. So, let's figure out if we still need to do something else. However, this should be the end of this section. And actually, let's end this section right now, because we still need to fix this, but we can do that in our next lesson, right? Because
every time it's time for refactor.
Yeah. So, finish the Let's Connect section. Cool. Push it. And it's time for us to go for a walk. And it's 20 past 2 a.m. here. So, yeah, and it's cold in London. So let's go for a walk and then we'll continue with his client. His paid client. Yeah. Cool.
Cool, guys.
Okay, so in the next lesson, we want to start working on the skill section, which you can see at the bottom over here.